you were there on Sunday morning, you know that we're going to go a little deeper on something that we didn't talk about. So we wanted to make sure we had time to approach God after the message. And that was a beautiful altar time, seeing you guys approach God. And the idea of being ready and waiting for that moment to have with Him is so special. So what I wanted to talk about is, see, we were there with Moses and the people of God at Mount Sinai right when they first got there. And they were preparing, and God said to take 3 days and prepare for Him to come down onto the mountain. And they were supposed to prepare and wait until the ram's horn blew. And then when that happened, they were to come to the mountain. But instead of coming to the mountain, they were afraid. They trembled, it said, and they did not approach God. Instead, Moses approached God. They stood at a distance. And so what I want to do, there's another time in the Bible when God's people had to wait 3 days to see Him. This was the 3 days after Jesus was crucified. Now, obviously, there in Moses' day, they were told they had 3 days. The disciples and the different followers of Jesus, they didn't know that they would have 3 days. But Jesus did tell them. He had prepared them and that He would die and then 3 days be raised. They just didn't pay attention to that part. And so what's interesting is when Jesus showed up, His disciples, they were just like the Israelites from Mount Sinai. They had been frozen in fear as well. But their fear wasn't of God. Their fear was of man. And I want to read something to you. It's in John chapter 20, verse 19. The first part of it says, "That Sunday evening, the disciples were meeting behind locked doors because they were afraid of the Jewish leaders." So you see, they were afraid of men. And so because they were afraid of men, they were frozen in their fear. And that was the key we talked about on Sunday, was actually knowing that our fear can either freeze us or it can free us. We can, and they mean set us free. And so Jesus wanted to set them free from their fear of man. And this is how He did it. Jesus showed up. And then for the following part of verse 19 of John chapter 20, and then verse 20 says, "Suddenly Jesus was standing there among them. 'Peace be with you,' He said. And as He spoke, He showed them the wounds in His hands and His side. And they were filled with joy when they saw the Lord." And here's the real. So we think, okay, awesome, right? They're not afraid when Jesus shows up. They were afraid of man, but when Jesus shows up, they're not afraid anymore. But the reality is they still had a fear of Jesus when He showed up. But it wasn't the fear of man. It wasn't the fear that freezes you. It was the fear that frees you, sets you free. We see it in Luke chapter 24, verse 37 and following. It says, "But the whole group was startled and frightened, thinking they were seeing a ghost." That's what happened when they saw Jesus. They were afraid when they thought He was a ghost. But Jesus says, "Why are you frightened? Why are your hearts filled with doubt? Look at My hands. Look at My feet. You can see that it's really Me. Touch Me and make sure that I am not a ghost, because ghosts don't have bodies as you see that I do." And as He spoke, He showed them His hands and feet. We just read that from John chapter 20. Still, they stood there in disbelief, filled with joy and wonder. See, once they realized it was Jesus, everything changed for them. They went from being afraid of man to having the fear of God, having the fear of Jesus. They went from hiding to healing. They went from denying to proclaiming. They went from freezing in fear of man to being free in their fear of Jesus. And so this is just like the fear of God. Because the fear of God is meant to free you, not to freeze you. It's a beautiful illustration how that same 3 day period in at Mount Sinai has a connection to the 3 day period to Jesus' resurrection. I hope you love the deeper dive. Loving our series in Moses as we continue through the journey. Like I said, lesson 5, we made it. So we'll see you guys this week. Take care.